properties. Yes, we different properties are there with the different statements. We studied about that all properties. Once we'll revise it once today, and we'll go next move on to the next content. Okay. Before we start, we'll start with a short prayer, children. Okay, all of you, close your eyes. Asitoma sagamaya, tamasoma jyotirgamaya, mrityoma amritam gamaya. Om shanti, shanti, shantihi. Okay. Now, in the previous class, we have six properties. Okay, six properties. That is first one, closer property. Closer property. Next one, associative communicative property. Third one, associative property. Fourth one, zero. Okay, multiplication by zero. I'm writing only shortcut today. Just we are revising. Fifth one is one. Okay, identity property. That is called as identity property. And the sixth one is distributive property. Distributive property. We'll write statement once, okay? In the side, I will write statements for this, okay? In the closer property, we have two integers, okay? When we multiply two integers, we get integer itself. We get integer itself. We may get A or B. Next one, commutative property. What is the commutative property, children? In the commutative property means we are just making a group and reversing it. Okay, if we have a A and B, just reverse it, B into A. This is called as a commutative property. The next one is associative property. When we have a three integers, okay, when we have a three integers, we may change the, we may group it in the different way, we get same answer. If we have a three integers, we may do like this. A into B, okay, here this in this way also we can make, or we may make in this way also, we may group it in the different way also. The zero, when we multiply any integer with a zero, we get zero itself. Identity property, when we multiply one with any integer, we get that integer itself. Okay, distributive property. In the distributive property, we take the help of addition. We take the help of addition. Okay, the distributive property is when we have three integers. Okay, when we have a three integers, here what we are using? Here we are using the addition. That is positive sign. Okay, B plus C. What we are doing? We are making a group here also, but we are taking the help of what? Addition. This may be written in the form of A into B plus A into C. This may be written as. This will help us to calculate the sum in the easier way. These are the properties of multiplication. These all are the properties of multiplication. Okay, children, we'll solve it, the sum of the sums on it, and we'll move on to the next one. The next one is multiplication in the easier way. The multiplication in the easier way. Okay, if we have a numbers like this, making a multiplication in an easier format. Okay, if we have a number like this, they given one example, 25 into 37 into 4. How you will calculate, children? You will do first, you will multiply these two. Okay, you will get a big number. After that, you make multiply with this. This will be little difficult now. Yes, it will be little difficult. So what we'll do? We'll make a group here. We'll make a group. Here we are using the what property we are using? Associative property we are using for this. Okay, we'll use the associative property. Make a group. Minus 25 into 37. Okay, into 4. Okay, take as a A, this is B, this is C. So I'm making like this, A into B into C. Associative property? Yes, it is associative property now. Okay, now you can calculate in the easier format. Rough, take a rough. Okay, calculate 25 into 37. 5 sevens are how much, children? 5 sevens are 35. 3 7 twos are 14. 15, 16, 17. Plus 5 threes are 15. 1 will be carry here. 6, 7. Okay, 5. Okay, 5, 9. No, 9. 7 plus 5 will be how much? 7 plus 5 will be 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 1 will be carry again. 7 plus 1 will be 8. 8 plus 1 will be 9. We got 925. 9 minus 925 we get, children. Why we are getting minus here? Because we have one side minus, one side positive. So minus into plus will be the minus. Okay. Now multiply with 4 now. 925 multiply with 4. Okay, directly we'll do it. We'll not do like that. We'll directly do, because we have a single number here. Okay. 4 5s are how much? 20. 2 will be carry here. 4 2s are 8. 9 10. 1 will be carry. 4 9s are 36. 37. We got minus 3700. Exactly we got. In your book also they given that much only, see. But these all calculations you have to do it in the rougher side. Where we have to do, children? Rougher side. I am stressing you again and again, what all calculation parts you are doing like this, you have to calculate in the rougher side. Okay. This is the one way of calculation. This is the one way of calculation, children. You can change this also, but you will get the same answer. In this, I need one format, okay? This is the one format. First format it is a format. You can change the format now. We can do like this also, but we get this much answer only. Okay? I will change the format. We'll multiply first minus 25. Okay? Minus 25 into 4. I did the group of these two and 37 out. Now multiply these two. 5, 20, 2, 8, 9, 10. Okay? 9, 10. Okay? We got how much? 100 we got, children. We got how much? We got 100. Minus 100 we got. How much we got? Minus 100. Now multiply these minus 100 with a 37. Minus 100 with a 37. We got what? We get what? 37,000 only, same we get, but we are doing the different format. Here I did the group between these two and I am taking 37 out. I am taking 37 out. Here I am doing these two groups. Okay, understood? These are the easier formats of making the multiplication. Easier way of making the our multiplication easy. Okay, in the easy way we can calculate it. Okay, children, now the same, so many problems are there. Depending on this, we can change the format and we can calculate. We can make our multiplication easier. On that, using the properties, we'll solve some problems now. Okay, children, in your textbook they given some problems. We'll solve it one by one. First one, page number 19, children. Find each of the following products. Find each of the following products. First one, minus 18 into minus 10 into 9. Okay, they given a three different numbers. Okay, three different numbers they given. Okay, we have to group it. Okay, minus 18 into minus 10. I'm making a group here. Okay, children, I am making a group here. Just we have to multiply these two. We get what? 18. Okay, 180 we get. Okay, 180 we get. Now multiply with 9. 9 zeros are 0. 9 is how much? Okay, we get how much? 162. Multiply this one, we get what? 1620. What we are doing? We are just making the group and we are taking the 9 outside. I am making these two groups and taking out 9 out. We can do the group like this also. We can take minus 18 into 9, okay, into minus 10. We can do like this also. But we get same answer. This much only answer we get. If we do the interchange of group, we get that answer only. Okay. The next question. In your textbook, they given one more problem. Four number they given. Four number. If they give four number, how to calculate the multiplication? Okay. Here they given a four number. Minus 20 into minus 2 into minus 5 into 7 they given. Okay. We have to make a group here also. We can make a group like this also. Okay. I am making group like this. Minus 20. Okay. Taking out into minus 2 into minus 5. Okay. Okay. And 7 also out. Here 20 is also out. And here 7 also out. We can do like this also, the grouping. And we can make group like this also. The another way grouping. Minus 20 into minus 2. One group. Into minus 5 into 7. We can make like this also. Okay. This will be the more easier than this. Okay. Which all things will be easier now, we have to apply that method. Calculate these two, you will get same answer. The answer will be what? Minus 1400 children. Try it once in a house. Please try it. You will get same for both methods. Both methods you will get same. Here also we get 1400. Minus 1400. Here also we get that much only. And here also we get 1400. Okay, turn the page now. Okay, 21, exercise 1.3 children. We'll move on to our exercise. Depending on properties, we'll solve the problems. Exercise number 1.3. Okay, first main. Find each of the following products. Find each of the following products. Each of the following products. Products means what? Multiplication. Products means what? Multiplication. Don't get confused that they are using other word. Product means multiplication only. When we get the answer, that is called as a product. Okay. First one. What is the first one? 3 into minus 1. Multiply any number with a 1. What we get? Multiply any number with a 1. That is a property of identity. The multiplication identity. Okay. The property. We are applying the property. Multiplying any number with a 1. That also minus 1. We get that number only. But the sign will be minus. The sign will be what? Minus. Okay, the next one, B. Same property, the multiplicative identity into 225. We get minus 225. We get minus 225. Third one, third problem. Minus 21 into minus 30. Multiply this children in the rough page, in the rough side, multiply this. Okay, what is the question? 21 into 30. Okay, 0 into 0, 1, 0, 0 to the 0, plus 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. 630 we got. Okay, 630 we got. Minus into minus will be what? Plus. Minus into minus will be what? Plus. So, answer is Yes, that calculation we did it in the rougher side. Only answer we are writing in this. Okay, the next question. What is the next question? Please copy this, children. Pause your video and then copy it. And again start your video, okay? Fourth question. -316 × -1. Here also identity property, that is -1. 1 is the identity, but here they are giving the sign. So that sign we are taking it, okay? Minus into minus will be plus, okay? 316 × 1 will be how much? 316 itself. Fifth one. -15 × 0 × -18. The multiplication property of 0. The multiplication property of 0. Okay, when we are multiplying any number with a 0, we get what? 0 itself. We get what? 0 itself. So, multiply 15 × 0, 0. 0 into 18 will be no use, negligible. 0 will be, 0 don't have any value. It will be a negligible value. But when we write 0 with any number, like for example, if we write 1 here, it gets value, okay? It gets value. When it is a single, then it will don't have any value. The next one. Sixth question. -12 × -11 × 10. Okay? -12 × -11 × 10. Multiply now. In the rougher side, multiply. First, we'll multiply 12 × 11. 1 2s are 2, 1 1s are 1, 1 2s are 2, 1 1s are 2. 3, 1 we got. Yes? 132. -into- will be what? Plus. So 132 × 10. Again we have to multiply. 132 × 10. How much, children? 0, 0, 0 plus 2, 3, 1. 1320. Here because we have a 2 minus, so answer will be plus only. Okay? Seventh question. 9 × -3 × -6. Okay? 3 9s are how much? -27. Okay? -27 × -6. Multiply these two, children. Again, rougher side. Multiply these two. How much we get? We get the answer will be what? 162 + 162. Okay, I'm writing plus because you will get the confusion. Okay, so I'm writing plus here. It is, if you don't write plus, plus is not needed. Okay, only minus we have to write. If nothing is there here, we think that it is a positive only. So, no need of writing plus. But when it is a minus, we have to write it. Because minus have a value. It have a lesser value. Positive have a greater value. Okay? Think about it and write the signs properly. Okay. Today's homework is homework for you. Okay. We did till what? We did till G. Okay. Homework. First main. H, I and J sums. Okay? H, I, J sum. You have to solve in which book? Homework book. Okay? We'll send you other sums in WhatsApp group. Okay, children? Please revise it once. Okay? Try to solve so many sums on that only. Use properties. Okay? Okay, children? See you in the next class. Please revise it. Bye.